Ooh, don't you just love a scrappy Xbox? I love myself a scrappy, scrappy Xbox. Hello, everyone. This is Jake, your resident content cowboy here, and I guess I'm starting to do that. Yeehaw! Today, I'm talking about Microsoft's decision to make online free-to-play games not require their Xbox Live membership. Some people are saying, "Hey, it's about time." I was hoping that would slurp, it didn't slurp. My big takeaway from all of this is, man, I love when Xbox is down. I love when they have to get scrappy. I love when they want to fight so hard to get people to play their console. I don't know if you all remember the dark days, the Xbox One days. Those are days I never want to go back to. I basically avoided the entire Xbox One generation because everything around it was awful. And now that Microsoft needs to fight again, they're making a lot of good decisions for us, the people who play games. That's what I care about. I don't care about which console wins. In fact, I love that all of the consoles do well enough that they still have to compete with each other to give consumers the best value possible. That's what I want to see. And right now, because Microsoft is behind, and yes, they are behind, they are fighting so hard with Game Pass and their Xbox Live service. They're just trying to do everything they can to gain some footing in the market. And I love it. I love a scrappy Xbox. Let me take you over to their announcement. We can read through it together and talk a little bit more about what this means. Online multiplayer for free-to-play games unlocked starting today. Today, we're sharing more details on our plans to make online multiplayer in free-to-play games available on Xbox without an Xbox Live Gold membership. As part of listening to your feedback, this change will take place starting today, and all Xbox players will be able to access online multiplayer at no charge for a library of over 50 free-to-play games that support online multiplayer. The full list is available on Xbox.com and below. The Xbox.com list will be updated with more free-to-play games post-launch. So obviously, it's going to depend a little bit on the developers and on the demand, and if these free-to-play games have ways for Microsoft to make money, of course. But this is Microsoft obviously moving away from the concept of Xbox Live in general because Game Pass is the real value that they want to push. And there are a lot of great games on here. Some of my favorites, Apex Legends, I think is amazing. A lot of people like Brawlhalla, Call of Duty Warzone. Man, I haven't played a Dead or Alive game in forever. Destiny 2, of course. Dungeon Defenders, I actually really like. Fortnite, never heard of it. Phantasy Star Online 2. God, I used to love my Dreamcast. Roblox, what's that? Rocket League, God, I love it. And the greatest game of all time, no joke, Smite. I love Smite. I had to stop playing Smite because I played too much Smite. It was all I played. Lots of great games here. Warframe. A lot of people like Warframe. And again, I recognize that this is a little behind some other consoles, but the point is, this is a move in the right direction. Microsoft keeps making moves in the right direction for their player base, and this is what you want. Even if you're on Sony, this is what you want. The whole reason Sony has that large collection of Sony classics to play when you get a PS5 is, of course, because they don't have a large, game library yet. Neither console has any games out for it that are next gen, really. But it's also because Microsoft has so much backwards compatibility and so much available on Game Pass. So they're competing. We want to see these two consoles do everything they can to earn our business. We don't want them to get to the point where they're going, "Yeah, whatever, it's great. You can't let your friends borrow a game. It has to come bundled with Kinect." We all remember that. And Sony smacked Microsoft around for it. One of the most embarrassing E3s for a company I've ever seen, and one of the greatest E3s for a company I've ever seen. Sony destroyed Microsoft there. And because Microsoft got destroyed, basically with that entire generation, the PS4 crushed the Xbox One. Now the Xbox has to fight. And I love it. I've got both. I've got my PS5 and my Series X back here. And they're both great, but I love my Series X. I really do. I think it's an awesome console, and I'm so excited for it. They're doing big things. They got Outriders day one. And I know it didn't work. It didn't work day one, but they got Outriders day one on Game Pass. Those moves would not be made if they were on top, crushing it and defeating everybody. Microsoft is fighting again, and I love to see it. Let me know what you think in the comments, what you really want to see out of Microsoft or out of Sony. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for being here. Oh, I didn't even say, if you have a chance, please like, comment, subscribe. It's free to you, but it means a lot to me. So if you like my channel and you want to support what I'm doing, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you all so much. I'll see you next time. I'm doing this apparently. Mwah!